la columna de Giovanni Frati. Los comentarios emitidos en esta columna son ajenos a Noticiero El Vigilante.
Hello, my dear friends. My name is Giovanni Frati, and I'm an attorney here in the city of Guatemala. And I just saw the hearing about Central American judicial independence that was done in the House of Representatives Committee on Human Rights. I praise both Democrats and Republicans for letting Guatemalans from both sides of the ideological spectrum, both from the far left and people from the right in Guatemala, give testimony, as well as allowing the Russian citizen that is exiled in Guatemala, Irina Bitko, which is a heroine of the fight against the corruption of the judicial system and the corruption of CICIG in Guatemala, to come to the committee. I praise the very special openness to hear both sides of the aisle and not just one side when it comes to Guatemala. I also have to praise Dr. González Dubón, the very distinguished professor of constitutional law in Guatemala, that gave his testimony. But I have to really wonder, how is it that the people from the other side, the leftists and the Democrats, lie so much about what's happening in Guatemala? Claudia Paz y Paz and this other guy, Mark Spencer, I think it was his last name, or Snyder, some experts, they say, on the Guatemalan situation, that don't know nothing about Guatemalan law or Guatemalan constitution, have gone to this hearing and outright lie and make false statements and lie directly to a commission of the United States Congress, which is, for me, amazing. First of all, they want to call heroes criminals that are fugitives from justice, from the Guatemalan justice system, such as Claudia Paz y Paz, Sandoval from the failed and the failure called FESI, which was basically the puppet of CICIG, another failure of the United Nations intervention in Guatemala that presided over a decade of a dictatorship, a judicial dictatorship against the basic human rights and the basic constitutional rights and the due process in Guatemala, prosecuting illegally a lot of Guatemalans and also the Bitko family. In the case of the Bitko family, that thank God was reported by the very distinguished American journalist Mary Anastasia O'Grady from the Wall Street Journal, in the Bitko case, they were in cahoots, they were in bed with the Russian ambassador, with the Kremlin, and they were partnering with the Russian embassy in Guatemala to destroy the Bitko family and to try to exile a three-year-old Guatemalan Russian child born in Guatemala of the Bitko family, a small child, Vladimir, that they wanted to exile to Russia, and that they threw in an orphanage in Guatemala where the little boy was abused and hurt, both psychologically and physically, and even they broke one of his teeth and mistreated him, didn't give him enough food, and it was basically torture. This is a shame for these judges that were in cahoots with the CICIG and an irregular diplomatic group in Guatemala called G13 that were the culprits of giving hundreds of millions of dollars, both to NGOs and to this failure called CICIG of the United Nations in Guatemala, that was supposedly established to fight corruption and became one of the most corrupt and destructive groups that have ever intervened in Guatemala. I think the lies that were said to this Human Rights Commission of the United States Congress are appalling. It really gives me pause and bewilderment of how easy these so-called experts go and lie to congressmen in the U.S. Congress. For instance, this guy, Schneider, says that thanks to CICIG, the rate of homicide in Guatemala were lowered. This is a complete lie. This has nothing to do whatsoever with CICIG or FESI, this corrupt prosecutor's office that was created inside of the Guatemalan prosecutor's office to do the bidding and to be the slave or the errand boy of this CICIG failure that was United States and United Nations intervention in Guatemalan judicial system. That was a complete and utter failure and was expelled from Guatemala for violating human rights and violating the Constitution. The homicide rate hasn't lowered because of CICIG or the United Nations. The homicide rate has lowered because there's been some very small economic growth in Guatemala for the last 10 years, And because there's a lot of brave policemen, Guatemalan policemen, Guatemalan attorneys, and Guatemalan judges that prosecute both the Maras, which are gang members, and assassins and murderers, and they throw them in jail. It has nothing to do whatsoever with United Nations or G13 or the U.S. Embassy in Guatemala. We as Guatemalans have been saying for 4 years now that what we want in cooperation with the United States is training and equipment for Guatemalan prosecutor's office, for Guatemalan attorneys and for Guatemalan judges and Guatemalan police, so that they can go to Quantico, Virginia, to the International Academy of the FBI to graduate foreign attorneys as U.S. special agents, so that we can start our own Guatemalan FBI and have cooperation with the FBI. We already have an office. It is called the Transnational Crime Combat Prosecutor's Office inside the General Attorney's Prosecutor Office of Guatemala that cooperates with the FBI, with the DEA, with the Department of Justice, and we also have a special prosecutor office against corruption. We don't need FESI anymore. We don't want corrupt lawyers such as Sandoval that have prevented, for instance, the huge Brazilian corporation called Odebrecht to pay the Guatemalan government more than $300 million of a fine because of the corruption in a contract of construction of a road in Guatemala that the corrupt Telmandana and the corrupt Sandoval from FESI went to Brazil to try to help this corrupt corporation, Odebrecht, and stop them illegally. Such as the attorney's office for the Guatemalan government has said in a specific study that they made about that illegal operation, they have stopped Odebrecht and helped Odebrecht to pay $300 million worth of a penalty for the Guatemalan government. And they also, in FESI, have presented false witnesses in front of Guatemalan judges, such as the witness admitted in front of the judge in the Valdez Pais case, and they have also prosecuted illegally, violating the Palermo Convention, which is an international convention of human rights to defend migrants that are trying to flee a dictatorship, such as the Vitco family was trying to flee to Guatemala, and they are already now in Guatemala trying to flee the Russian dictatorship and corruption and murder regime of Putin, and they went against this family illegally, even though the Palermo Convention protected them. So the injustices and the huge violations to the rule of law that these so-called corruption fighters have done in Guatemala, it's appalling. It's really amazing the amount of lies and misconstructions that both Claudia Paz Ypaz and this Schneider guy went and said to congressmen in the United States Congress today. And I'm doing this video in English to protest against the lies and to commend and to praise the bravery of Dr. Gonzalez Dubon and Irina Vitcom of the Vitcom family, and Gonzalez Dubon from Liga Pro Patria, a civic group in Guatemala that have been fighting against the corruption of CICIG, the corruption of these G13 irregular group of ambassadors that are very abusive, and they have been destroying the Guatemalan rule of law for at least a decade, both with Gloria Porras, a corrupt magistrate from the Constitutionality Court, and with Telmandana and Sandoval, which are corrupt ex-prosecutors or current prosecutors in the Attorney's Office of Guatemala. We don't want U.S. intervention inside Guatemalan offices and Guatemalan entities, but what we want is cooperation and training so that we can have professional prosecutors that prosecute crime based on scientific evidence and not on media circus like CICIG does and like the corrupt FESI does. We want FESI closed because it's an unconstitutional entity that makes the bid for foreigners. And if you don't believe me that nobody in Guatemala wants them or is behind them, just look at the last public calling for a manifestation and for protests in the central park of Guatemala, one of the main squares of the Guatemala city, in which all the left and all the NGOs called for support for this Sandoval guy from FESI, and not even 10 people showed up to the Guatemalan Central Park, which is the main square of the Guatemala city, in the old Guatemala city here in Central America. Not even 10 people showed up to support Sandoval and or FOPA, another corrupt prosecutor from FESI. FESI is a corrupt entity, congressmen and people in the United States and in Guatemala, and we have to fight against corruption, even if it comes from some corrupt political people or politicians from the United States or from the United Nations or from these G13 irregular groups. We are going to fight corruption, we are going to fight the violation of the rule of law, and we're going to fight the violation of the Guatemala Constitution, because this is our country. We are a sovereign country, and we need to impose our sovereignty, and we need to fight for the rule of law, no matter who violates the rule of law, both in Guatemala and in the United States. Please, United States government, stop harboring Guatemalan criminals, such as Tel Maldana and Gloria Porras, and extradite them to Guatemala to face justice. Like the brave journalist Mary Anastasia Grady said in her article in the Wall Street Journal, if they have nothing to fear, then have them show their face in the Guatemalan court that is waiting for them to prosecute them for the crimes, but several crimes that they committed in Guatemala. My name is Giovanni Frati. I'm an opinion journalist and an attorney here in the city of Guatemala. You can follow me at Frati Giovanni, my Twitter page, or Giovanni Frati Periodista, Giovanni Frati Journalist, my Facebook page. Good afternoon.
La columna de Giovanni Frati. Los comentarios emitidos en esta columna son ajenos a Noticiero El Vigilante.